going to learn how to represent a irrational number on a Lamma line. Let's see how. In our exercise 1.2, question number 3 is given. So, how root 5 can be represented on a Lamma line? Now here, root 5, does not have any value and any answer for root 5, any perfect answer for root 5, because it is non-terminating and non-repeating number if we are going to solve root 5. So, this is a irrational number. So, now this irrational number we have to show. If it is 5, so then you can show it on number line very easily. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, you can say 5. But how you will show root 5 on a number line? For that, you have to remember a formula, that is Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem is not new for you, because in 8th standard you are already aware of this term, Pythagoras theorem. In that, you have learned that hypotenuse square is equal to sum of square of two sides. And what is hypotenuse? In any right angle triangle, let's say OAB is a right angle triangle at O. So the opposite side of the right angle is hypotenuse, and rest of the two sides are, you can say, base and altitude, and either you can say S1, side 1 and side 2. Okay friend? So here, as per this rule, we can say AB square, that is the hypotenuse square, is equal to side 1 square plus side 2 square, that is AO plus OB square. Okay? Now, if you take this square to other side of equal to, so it will form a whole root of these two sides square. Okay friend? Now, let's take an example first. Let's say we are having a triangle whose two sides OA and OB are of one unit. Now here you can take one unit as 2 centimeters. Okay friend? Or 3 centimeters as per your wish. Okay, it is not mandatory, but it should be one unit. Both the sides should be one unit. If you are take 2 units, okay, now here in our question we are taking 1 unit equal to 2 centimeter, so it will be 2 into 2, so 4 centimeter will be the 2 unit. If we are talking about 3 unit, so now you can understood that 3 into 2 centimeter, that is 6 centimeter we are going to take. Okay friend, so we are taking here 1 unit, both side 1 unit. So you have to draw 2 centimeter line here and 2 centimeter line here. So how to draw? First of all, we take a ray OX. On that, A is a point 2 centimeter away from O. And draw perpendicular line at O. That is B. OB is 1 unit, that is 2 centimeter, because we have taken 1 unit equal to 2 centimeters. So now if you apply Pythagoras theorem here, so our AB is a hypotenuse, so AB square is a side 1 square plus side 2 square whole root. So here side 1 is 1 unit, that is 1 square, and side 2 is also 1 unit, that is 1 square again and whole root. So 1 plus 1 is 2 whole root. So 2 root is your answer. Okay friend, that means the length of this AB is root 2. Root 2 is also irrational. Now our question is to find out the root 5. So here we will take 2 unit, length of one side equal to 2 unit, and length of other side is same as 1 unit. So here we will take OB as 4 centimeter and OA as 4 centimeter and OB as 2 centimeter, because we have already assumed that 1 unit equal to 2 centimeters. Okay friend? So now if in this triangle we apply Pythagoras theorem, so as per that theorem, hypotenuse, AB is the hypotenuse equal to square of one side, that is 2 unit, 2 square, and square of other side, that is 1 unit, that is 1 square. So 2 square is equal to 4, and 1 square equal to 1 whole root on both of them. So now if you add them, so we will have 5 here, so 5 root. So in any triangle, it is proven that by this method, if you take one side as 2 unit and other side as 1 unit, then the hypotenuse will become, the value of hypotenuse will become root 5. Yes friends, let's see next exercise 1.3. First question of 1.3 is, write the following in decimal form. First question given here is 36 upon 100. This 36 upon 100 will be, we have to convert it into decimal. How? So we use division method. So 36 will be divided by 100. As 36 is less than 100, so we first use decimal. Here we can use 0. So first we will take 3 za. So 300, 60 will remain. Then again we can take 0 here. So 6 za now, 600. Now our division is over and our answer is 0.36. So we converted 36 upon 100 in decimal form, that is 0.36. Same way we have to convert 1 by 11. So again we will divide 1 by 11. Now here also we use decimal first, 0. Now after using 1 0, still the value is less than the divisor, that is 11. So we use another 0 here. Okay, so by this 9 we can take as a divisor. So now 1 will remain. Again 1 0 we can use, but for other 0 we have to use another 0 in quotient. Then again it is 100, 9, and this will go on and on. So by converting 1 by 11 as decimal, we have 0.090909, so on. Now this you can also write in this notation. You have to put a dash above the numbers repeated, or you can put dots above them, or you can also write it like this. Okay friend, so these are the different method in which you can represent repeated non-terminating numbers. Okay. Now third question given is 4 integer 1 by 8. Now we have to convert it into vulgar form first. So you know 4 will be multiplied by 8 and 1 will be added to that product. So we'll have 33 upon 8 here. Now it is very simple. You can solve it. You divide 33 by 8. Whatever the answer is there, that is your answer. Okay. Now come to next question. Question number 2. It says 1 by 7 equal to 0.142857 whole bar. That means these numbers are repeated again and again, as we had already seen our last question. So this value is given. We have to find out 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7 and 6 by 7. These are the other values that we have to find out. Okay friend. Now for first part, 2 by 7 we have to find out. So here you can write 2 by 7 as 2 into 1 by 7. Okay. Now 2 as it is, but in place of 1 by 7 we can write a value of 1 by 7. Okay, that is given in the question. Now find out the product. Now the whatever the answer comes, you use whole bar on that answer. Okay friend. Now in same method, same pattern, we can solve 3 by 7. So take 3 as a multiply and 1 by 7. Okay, this is the product of 3 and 1 by 7. So 3 as it is, in place of 1 by 7, you write the value of 1 by 7. Now do the product also. Here, whatever the answer, put a whole bar on that. So your answer is same. Now you have to do 4 by 7, 5 by 7 and 6 by 7 as per these two methods.